guys! So today I wanted to do a quick get ready with me. Will it be quick though? We don't know. Probably not. But yeah, I wanted to do a get ready with me. I also wanted to do a first impressions of this brush set. So this is the multi-purpose makeup brush. And basically these are supposed to be a dupe for the Artis toothbrush shaped brushes. I did actually try to film a get ready with me before, however it didn't go so well and then I lost the footage, so I'm just gonna do it in a kind of like informal get ready with me today. So this is what the brushes look like. They look very much like the Artis ones, the rose gold ones, and yeah, I bought them from eBay for $10.99, I think it was. I'll try and list it below. All of the products as well will be listed in the description box. So if you want to get ready with me, grab your makeup and let's get into the video. First things first, I'm just going to prime my face. So I'm going to be using the Maybeline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser, and I just apply a pea-sized kind of blob. Don't know if you can see that at all. There you go. It's just a very, very small blob.
So I'm just going to rub that in between my fingers and then push it into my skin where I need it. Just generally just the centre of my face.
And I'm actually just going to use a damp sponge quickly just to press that in a little bit more and also get rid of the excess. So the foundation I'm using today is the Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation. This one is in the shade, I think it's just vanilla or, yeah, light vanilla.
I love the smell of this foundation. It smells really nice. It's not like overpowering either.
Which is really good. So I'm just going to pump one, two pumps onto my palette. Then I'm also going to use some of the Body Shop shade adjusting drops in lightening. And I'm just squeezing a few of those onto my palette. The brush that I'm going to use to apply my foundation is the number 2 brush.
So for comparison, this is number 1, this is number 2. I feel like number 1's going to be a bit too big and a bit too solid, whereas number 2 feels better.
Okay, so I'm just going to pat my brush into this. Do you know what, actually I'm going to apply it to my face with my fingers. I think that'll be a better idea. Not liking putting the brushes in there. So I'm just going to dot this around my face. Okay, let's give this a go. So the last time I did this, I just tried to use my camera viewfinder instead of a mirror. And so I found it was really, really streaky and horrible and I didn't know how to fix it. Also, the last time I did this, my skin was terrible. I mean, it's not the best at the moment, but it's not as bad as it was. So I feel like this is going to go slightly better this time. I don't feel like I gave them a fair chance last time I tried to film this. But that doesn't matter anyway because I lost the footage. Everything was going wrong that day. Okay, so far actually it's doing a lot better than it was last time. It might be my primer that I've used or the fact that my skin's better. But yeah, I think it's looking okay so far.
I'd say that's done a fairly even job. It's not
looking streaky like it was last time. It's given me quite a nice coverage as well, and it's not picked up on the brush, which is good. So I'm just going to apply a second layer over the centre of my face where I feel like it needs it, and then we will move on to concealer and such. Okay. I'm going to try a little stippling motion. No, definitely don't stipple, that doesn't help. And I'm not applying very much pressure with the brush at all. And I'm being extra specially gentle on my nose because I know that area doesn't really like to hold. well so far. I don't think this really saves time at all. If I was using a sponge, I'd be done by now with my foundation. I feel like it's quite therapeutic to do it this way. But definitely not the way I'd apply my makeup every day or if I was in a rush, really. Next, we're going to do a bit of concealer and also a bit of cream contour.
So, for my concealer, I am going to be using
this brush, and this one is the number 5. So just a quick comparison again. This is the one we've used on our face. This is the number 5, which is the smallest of this kind of shape brush. And I'm going to be using my Naked Skin Complete Coverage Concealer by Urban Decay. This is in the shade Fair Neutral, so it's the lightest shade that they do, because I'm fairly pale. So I'm just going to apply this as I normally would. I'm going to blend in my concealer over the centre of my face first, and then I'm going to do my eyes afterwards because I like to be able to set that as soon as possible. So let's see how this does. And I'm being very extremely gentle with this brush because I feel like it's less smooth than the other brushes. The bigger brushes seem to be more smooth and like easier to blend. But actually, this is like making my concealer go so much further than it usually does. That's amazing. So now I'm going to try and blend out the concealer underneath my eyes. And then immediately after that, I'm going to try and bake. I'm going to be using my NYX HD Studio Photogenic Setting Powder, and this is the translucent one. I talked about this in a haul recently, so this is where I'm testing it out. I haven't actually really tested it out at all yet, so we'll try and set my under eyes with that, shall we?
Do a little bit of baking.
So I'm going to use the same brush to blend out my concealer, and then I'll probably use a sponge to apply the powder to bake. Also, I am noticing that there's more brush strokes using this smaller brush than there were with using the larger brushes. That's better. And then I'm going to use my beauty blender, which is damp. I'm going to dip it directly into my powder and pick up a whole bunch of it. And then I'm just going to place that underneath my eye. So I'm just going to leave that there to bake while I do some contouring. For my contour today, I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution Ultra Cream Contour Palette. The shade that I'm going to be using, I think I might try and mix two shades together. I think I'm going to mix these two together to do my contour. And I am going to use the number 4 brush.
So here's the brush we used for our concealer, and this is the brush that I'm using for my contour, so it's slightly bigger. I'm just going to contour my cheekbones, and I might give my forehead a little contour, but I doubt it because I don't feel like I need to.
So I'm just going to go directly into that one, the brush, and then directly into the next one with the brush. And then I'm just going to find my cheekbone. And draw a line there.
Look at you, stop! Try to film. You said I'm going to film, and the whole world starts trying to contact me, and the one is not doing nothing, and then we have to.
And I'm just going to dip back into the concealer contour again because I just felt like that line was a little bit less prominent than the other one. And of course, even though they both look a little bit too intense, need them both to be even because otherwise we'll have uneven contour. Now I'm just going to take what's left on the brush around the top of my head. So yeah, I am going to use this brush here, which is the number 3.
So I again. This is the foundation brush that I used, the number 2 brush, and this is the number 3 brush. So they're fairly similar in size, just the number 3 is obviously a little bit smaller. I'm just going to use that to buff out my contour.
So I've had my bake on for about 5 to 10 minutes, I would say now. So I'm just going to knock that off, and I'm going to use this brush here, which is the number 1 brush. It's the biggest brush in the set, and I'm just going to use that to knock off the powder. I'm now going to set the rest of my face, and I'm going to be using my MAC Studio Sculpt defining powder, and this is in the shade Light. As you can see, it's fairly loved. I hit pan on it quite a while ago, so it is getting a bit crumbly. I'm just going to use the number 1 brush to set everything. And I'm going to avoid my contour area because I'm going to be using a contouring powder to set. It has rubbed off all of the product on my nose though, but I find that usually happens whether I use a beauty blend or not. Just can't seem to get stuff to stay on my nose really. Just loading it up again with some more of the powder, just to do my forehead. And I'm actually going to blend the powder just to make it all look a little bit more even.
Oh bugger, I was going to come to my nose. And you know what, everything's practically gone off my nose anyway, so I could come to my nose. Let's do it, shall we?
Right. So I'm going to use the number 6 brush to contour my nose, and I'm going to use the lighter contour shade, just this one here. And then I'm just going to blend out slightly with a damp sponge again. I feel like these brushes are good for initially placing the product, especially like cream products, and then you can go over it with a damp sponge and it just makes everything look a little bit more flawless, because you get the nice coverage from the brush and then the nice finish from the sponge. For the centre of my nose, I'm going to use the, I think this is the number 9 brush, this is the flat eyeshadow brush, but yeah, I'm not using it for my eyeshadow today because I want to do something very specific. So I'm going to take a mixture of this colour and this colour. This is like the banana colour and then the concealer colour. And then I'm just going to draw that down the centre of my nose. I'm just going to pat it out with my finger slightly. And then again I'm going to go in with my damp sponge just to blend out the edges. That seems to have worked pretty well. So now it is time to move on to setting the contour with some powder contour. For my powder contour, I am going to be using the NYX HD blush in Taupe and the number 4 brush. This one is the second smallest toothbrush shaped brush, and I'm going to very, very lightly just press it into... I'm not even really pressing it, I'm just like hovering it over and turning the brush slightly into the powder. And then I'm going to proceed with caution because I'm really scared about this. So now I'm going to go in with some blush. Probably going to regret this decision, but I'm going to use my MAC Mineralize blush in the shade Gleeful. This is one of my favourite blushes. If you are looking for a similar product to this, a similar finish to this, then I would recommend the Natural Collection highlighter stick in the shade Coral Glow. it has the same kind of effect as this blush does. So this blush has like golden reflex in it, and so does this coral glow highlighter stick. And it actually turns out more like a blush than a highlighter, I'd say, on my skin tone anyway. But yeah, they have the same sort of colour and the same sort of reflective finish as well, which is what I like so much about this blush. And I use this on days where I want to look a little bit more natural, but you can build this up quite a lot. I'm going to use the number 4 brush again, just because I feel like it's a good size. And I'm going to, again, very lightly, because this MAC blush is super pigmented. Like, I've had this for 3 years and I used it every day for about 2 years, so, and I've barely made a dent in it at all. It's crazy, crazy pigmented. So that already looks like far too much on the brush. I'm not sure if it's picking up on camera, but the brush is now pink and I barely even tickled the pan with that. Oh yeah, that's a really nice finish. I'm really happy with that. And actually, I don't think I had too much blush on. So the last thing I'm going to attempt to use these brushes for is my highlighter. And today I am going to use the number 5 brush, which is the same brush that we used for the contour. And I'm going to try and use my Jeffree Star highlighter, Jeffree Star Skin Frost, in the shade Mint Condition. But yeah, I'm going to try and use that with the number 4 brush, which is the smallest toothbrush shaped brush.
I'm actually pleasantly surprised it's not too intense.
Okay, so I'm going to zoom you in for a closer look now. So.
Okay, so I don't know if you can see on my nose here, but I've got loads of like dry, patchy flakiness, which looks horrible. But the rest of my face, I feel like, besides this pimple here, which I decided not to try and cover anymore, I feel like the rest of my face looks really good, apart from, yeah, my nose. And maybe some areas on my forehead where it's a little bit drier, like here. Don't know if you can see that, but in person it's quite flaky looking. I did apply a moisturiser beforehand. But yeah. Overall, I'm fairly happy with the way these brushes are working. Yeah, don't really have many complaints apart from obviously personal skin problems, really. But yeah, I feel like they did a better job than the last time I tried them, which went horrifically wrong. I wish I had the footage so that I could insert the clip, but the footage is gone. My memory card malfunctioned, thankfully, because it was awful, terrible. Like, I nearly cried. It was so bad.
Okay, so I finished the rest of my face. As you can see, I have done my favourite eye look of the moment. This is a look that I wore in one of my previous videos, and somebody actually asked me to do a tutorial on it. So, lucky you, I've actually filmed the tutorial, and that will be coming up in a separate video. So, my overall impression of these brushes, to be honest, today I'm having a bit of a dry skin day, so in the areas of my face, like my forehead and my nose and my chin, where I'm a little bit more dry at the moment, these brushes haven't done a good job. I feel like if I'd just used a damp sponge, I wouldn't have the dry flaky patches that I've got going on at the moment. However, I would say that the brushes are actually pretty decent. I mean, I wouldn't use them on their own. I definitely would use them in combination with my beauty blender. I would definitely use them in combination with my beauty blender or my Real Techniques sponge, just to kind of smooth everything out afterwards and put a bit more of that moisture back in. But yeah, for coverage and for, I don't know, therapy, I would say these are very, very good brushes. Definitely save your money and buy those instead of the Artis brushes, I would say. Although personally I haven't used the Artis brushes, so I don't know whether that is really of any use to you or not. Let me know if there's anything else that you'd like me to test out. I'm planning on maybe doing a testing a certain brand of makeup video. I'm sure you've probably seen a couple of those hanging around on YouTube. So let me know if there's a specific one that you want to see. Bear in mind that I am in the UK, so it will have to be a UK brand if you're not UK based. But yeah, let me know in the comments section down below what you'd like me to test out. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, if you found it helpful. Again, all the products that I've used will be listed below just in case I forgot to mention any of them. And yeah, if you haven't subscribed already, please hit the subscribe button. It's totally free, doesn't cost you anything, and then you'll never miss one of my videos ever again. So it's a win-win situation. Anyway, I will see you in the next video. Thanks, bye.